Well, Tom, most members of this freshman class won on a message of change. But before they take action in Concord, they've got to learn how action is taken. It is a day to find their way around the corridors of power. 11 future senators and more than 150 new state reps, many of them Republicans with an eye on reform, are getting their freshman orientation.
I think we want to make change.
Incoming Representative Joseph Petrie from Farmington is joining the conservative House Republican Alliance and plans to call for cuts.
The money is just not there, and you can't keep squeezing the people.
But first, there is a learning curve. For Senator-elect Tom DeBlois, a Manchester real estate investor in business for 44 years, this is just his second time ever in the State House.
It's like going to college and being on the campus for the first time. You're full of anticipation, expectation.
Forgive freshman Democrats if they aren't as excited.
I do feel kind of surrounded.
Representative-elect June Frazier of Concord says the minority still has a voice.
We have an important role to play, so I'm looking forward to that.
But roles for both sides are in question, even with one party in firm control.
This is the largest class of new folks that we've ever had up here, at least in my memory.
Representative David Welch of Kingston has spent more than 25 years under the dome and says the GOP can't just rely on its numbers.
You would think that with a supermajority that you can do anything that you want, but it doesn't work out that way.
Some faces are only changing places. Nancy Stiles spent 6 years in the House and is now moving on to the Senate. She says Republicans must make good on promises of fiscal restraint and efficient government.
Those are the things that we need to work together to do and accomplish. Otherwise, we'll be gone next time.
Now, orientation continues tomorrow, and of course, all eyes will be on the Republicans Thursday as they select a new Speaker of the House. Adam Sexton, WMUR News 9.